Hello everyone, this is Professor Pavan Shivankar and I welcome you in the 36th lecture of Control System Engineering. And in today's lecture, we are going to solve root locus. So we have covered all the rules except last two rules, that is angle of departure and angle of arrival. So let us complete some simple numericals in which there is no complex pole and complex zero. So numerical is, for unity feedback system, G of S is K by S, S plus 4, S plus 2. Sketch rough nature of root locus showing all details on it and comment on the stability of the system. So our question is, G of S into H of S equal to K by S, S plus 4, S plus 2. So very first rule is number of pole and number of zero. So what are the values of S written in denominator are known as pole, and the value of S in numerator are known as zeros. So there is no value on numerator. So pole P equal to, how many poles are available? 1, 2, 3. And the values are 0, minus 4, minus 2. Got it? Now, 0. No S values are present in the numerator, so Z is 0. Got it? Then, number of branches. Number of branches of root locus. That is capital N equal to. So, how many root locus we are going to draw for this numerical? Higher number among pole and zero. So higher number is 3. So number of branches are 3. Got it? Clear? Now, next is root locus region. Root locus region. So here I am showing root locus region roughly, not on graph paper. So this is a S plane, and plot all the poles by cross and zeros by circle. So pole are at 0, minus 2 and minus 4. So 0, minus 2, minus 4. Got it? Then the region will be, region hum kaise banayenge, infinity to 0, 0 to minus 2, minus 2 to minus 4, and minus 4 to minus infinity. These are the regions. Now we need to check root locus region, whether root locus exists or not in particular given region. So infinity to 0, consider one point, check on right hand side of that point and count number of pole and zero. So on right hand side of this point, this marking, there is no pole and zero available. So non root locus region from infinity to 0. Then between 0 to minus 2, on right hand side of this point, this one, okay, on right hand side of this point, if we count number of pole, one pole is there, so one is odd figure, so this is a root locus region. So here between minus 2 to minus 4, on right hand side of this point, number of poles are 1 and 2. 2 is odd figure, that's why this is a non root locus region. On the right hand side of this point, number of poles are 1 and 2. 2 is even figure, even, that's why this is a non-root locus region. And obviously, between minus 4 to minus infinity, if you take any point and checking on the right hand side, so number of poles are 1, 2, 3. 3 is odd figure, that's why this is a root locus region. Okay, so NRL, RL, NRL, RL. So this is about the root locus region. Now next, next is angle of asymptote. Angle of asymptotes. So formula for angle of asymptote is twice q plus 1 into 180 by p minus z, where q equal to 0, 1 up to p minus z minus 1. Okay, q value ends on p minus z minus 1. So what will be the value of q? See, p is 3, z is 0, so 3 minus 0, 3, 3 minus 1, 2. Up to 2, we need to calculate theta. So 2 means 0, 1 and 2. Got it? So put q is equal to 0 in formula, you will get one value. Then later on replace q is equal to 1, then consider q is equal to 2 and calculate three values. So theta 1, theta 2 and theta 3. So if you put q is equal to 0, so 0 plus 1, 1, 1 into 180 by p minus z, that is 3, so it is 60. So you will get 60, 180 and 270. So these are the angle of asymptote. You can calculate it. Put q is equal to 1, you will get 180. Put q is equal to 2, you will get 270. Okay. Then next part, after angle of asymptote, next is centroid, location of asymptote. So centroid sigma is equal to, and the formula is summation of real part of pole minus summation of real part of 0 divided by p minus z. So sigma equal to summation of real part of pole. So sabhi pole ki real values, we have only real poles. So 0, minus 4 and minus 2. So summation of 0 plus minus 4 plus minus 2. 0 plus minus 4 plus minus 2 minus summation of real part of 0. We don't have 0, so simply 0 here. Divide by p minus z, that is 3 minus 0, 3. So sigma is equal to minus 6 by 3. So minus 6 by 3 is minus 2. So this is a centroid. Got it? Now next, we have done with the region of root locus existence, then angle of asymptote, location of asymptote. The next point is breakaway point. Breakaway point. What is breakaway point? So how to calculate breakaway point is what? It is a point where two branches of root locus coming to each other and will collide. The collision point is known as a breakaway point. So procedure is, first one, characteristic equation. So 1 plus g of s into h of s equal to 0. So consider this equation. 1 plus g of s is k by s plus 4 s plus 2 equal to 0 because h of s equal to 1. So solve this now. I am solving these brackets. So s square plus 4s. So 1 plus k by s square plus 4s and s plus 2 equal to 0. So we'll get 1 plus k by s cube plus 2s square plus 4s square plus 8s equal to 0. So equation C here, cross multiplication with 1, so s cube plus 2s square plus 4s square, that is 6s square plus 8s plus k, this cross multiplication, plus k equal to 0. Okay, now this is the first step, consider characteristic equation. Then second step is write down the whole equation for the value of k, that means k equal to minus in bracket s cube plus 6 s square plus 8 s, that's it. Then step number 3, differentiate equation with respect to s and equate with a 0. So dk by ds equal to 0. So differentiate this equation with respect to s and equate with a 0. So derivative of s cube, 3s square plus 6 into 2, 12s plus 8 equal to 0, minus n equate with a 0. So this is the equation. Now roots of these equations will give us breakaway point. So solve this equation on a calci. And if we solve this equation on calci, we'll get minus 0.48. This value is minus, okay, and second value is minus 2.48. Wait a minute. Minus 2.48. So now we need to check which one is valid and which is not valid. So minus 0.48 and minus 2.48. So it should be checked with the help of root locus region. So 0.48 and minus 2.48. This value comes in 0 to minus 2, obviously. So this is a valid value. Now look for this value, minus 2.48. Minus 2.48 will come in minus 2 to minus 4, which is of non-root locus region. So it is invalid. As simple as that. Okay. So our breakaway point is minus 0.48. Hence, valid breakaway point is minus 0.48. Got it? So this is all about the breakaway point. Now what is next? Next is intersection with the imaginary axis. Okay. Now next is intersection with imaginary axis. Okay, our next point is intersection with imaginary axis. So intersection with the imaginary axis. So very first step is characteristic equation. We already generated characteristic equation in the last step, and which is got as s cube plus 6 s square plus 8 s plus k. S cube plus 6 s square plus 8 s plus k equal to 0. This is a characteristic equation. Now for intersection with imaginary axis, our second step is to construct roots array. So first of all, check the equation or the order of equation. It should be complete: s cube, then square, then single s, and then constant. So complete order available here. So highest power is cube, then next is square, later on single s, and s raised to 0. The coefficients of s cube is 1, then leave next one, later on 8, then leave next one, later on nothing is available, that's why 0. We need to select, or we need to write coefficients like this fashion: 1, leave 6, then 8, leave k, then 0. Then coefficient of s square is 6, so 6, then k, then nothing is there, so 0. Now for s, to get s, 6 into 8 minus 1 into k divided by 6. Minus k by 6. Here 6 into 0 minus 1 into 0 divided by 6, that is a 0, and s is to 0. So 48 minus k divided by 6 into k minus 6 into 0 divided by same term, that is a, we'll get only k here. Now from s raised to 0 row, k is greater than 0, then s raised to 1 row, 48 minus k by 6 equated with 0. Actually it is more than 0, but for calculation of k, equate this with a 0. So we will get 48 minus k equal to 0. So k marginal, this is known as a k marginal value. So k marginal is 48. Okay, now we get k marginal value. Then from s raised to 2 row, we will get auxiliary equation. So auxiliary equation is here 6, so 6 s square plus, sorry, 6 s square plus k equal to 0. So 6 s square plus value of k is 48 equal to 0. So s square plus 8 equal to 0. Okay, hence s equal to 8. So we should get it is a 2 root 2 and under root 8, let me check it, under root 8 is 2.82 I, so plus minus. Okay, so value is 2.82 I, because S is under root minus 8. So this is a complete calculation. Now with the all values we need to draw root locus. So in front of you, you can see graph paper. If you don't have any poles which are a positive, here you can see all the poles are negative and no zero. So try to shift your whole root locus as possible as on right hand side. Like, I am not drawing imaginary axis on exactly at the middle, so I will take a line here. Suppose this is imaginary axis, this is real axis. Use scale, graph should be very spread. Okay, now poles are at 0, then suppose 1, I'm taking a scale of 2, suppose, so 1, then 2, suppose 3 and 4. Okay, nothing is here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then mark all silent features on this. So where is your centroid? Centroid is as sigma equal to minus 2 here itself. Okay, this one. And from the centroid, draw all the asymptotes. Write down like theta 1 is equal to 60 degree. Secondly, and you should draw your angles by exact measurement. It should not be approximate, it should be accurate. Theta 3 and theta 2 will be at 180. So theta 2 equal to 180 degree. Theta 3 is 270 degree. Okay, with the exact measurement you need to draw all these asymptotes. So we have drawn, we have shown asymptote, we have shown angle of asymptote as well as location of asymptote. Now the next point is breakaway point. And what was our valid breakaway point? Valid breakaway point was minus 0.48. okay, suppose this is a 1, this is a 0.5, so nearby here. Okay, break away point equal to minus 0.48. This all points, all the silent features you should clearly to be shown on graph paper. This is the real axis, sorry, imaginary axis, this is the real axis. So infinity to minus infinity. Now the next part is, next calculation part is intersection with imaginary axis. So we got point plus minus 2.82 I. So mark on imaginary axis, suppose this is 1, 2, this is a 3, and little bit less than 3, suppose here. So here this is a 1, this is a 2, and this is a 3, so suppose here this value is 2.82i, and this is minus 2.82i. okay, now actual root locus we are going to draw. These are the all the calculation part that we have completed for the numerical. Now we are going to draw actual root locus. So I'm changing the ink color of ink, so you can see clearly the root locus. First of all, this is a pole, another pole is here, and third pole is here. Okay, if you check root locus region, so this is a NRL non-root locus region, so we can't draw root locus in this side, we need to draw on this side. This is a second pole, and if we check in minus 2 to minus 4, this is a non-root locus region. We can't draw root locus on this side, so root locus should be drawn in this side. So arrows has a great importance actually, because these are showing where exactly root locus is moving. So one root locus from this pole will go in this side, another root locus from this pole goes on this side. Okay, so show the arrow. This is a point of collision known as a breakaway point. So branches will split and exactly split in vertical up and down like this and like this. So again show arrow. Then these are the intersection with imaginary axis. Actually the role of root locus is to follow the asymptote, because what are the asymptote? Asymptote are the guidelines. They guide your root locus to travel along the infinity. So your root locus started from this pole, another root locus started from this pole, they collide at this point known as a breakaway point, then they split, they divide in the branches, and then they will travel not from this side, from this point. Okay, so let me erase that part again. This one, so after splitting, after breakaway point, they have to pass through intersection point like this, and at bottom again they go from this point, and parallel to asymptote this root locus go to infinity. Along this asymptote, this root locus will follow this asymptote at 60 degree. Okay, and they are approaching to infinity. Now two root locus has been completed. Now the third root locus, because there is one more pole here and one more asymptote remain left. So this root locus, this pole has one root locus, so root locus will start from this pole and follow the asymptote like this. It will go to infinity along the asymptote. So root locus always start from pole, end on zero, and it will follow the asymptote. So whatever the calculation and assumptions we made this before, it is to be satisfied completely. Like root locus always start from pole, so we have started two root locus from this pole, then root locus should follow the asymptote, either they may overlap or they may be parallel. So after drawing this root locus and from the intersection point, it's following like it is going to infinity but parallel to this asymptote. So three asymptotes are there, so three branches should follow the infinity. So this root locus, this asymptote, this root locus, this asymptote, and there is one more asymptote like 180. So this root locus will follow 180 asymptote. So this is a complete solution for given numerical. Again, you should write at intersection point, you should write like at k equal to, we got k is equal to 48 and the frequency was 2.82 radian per second, omega n equal to. Okay, so what are the intersection point you will get? You should write at value of k, you get k is equal to 48 and omega n is equal to 2.82 radian per second. Got it? Clear? Now last part, that is a comment on stability. Comment. So what comment we should do? Comment like, see, first of all the poles are lying on left hand side of S plane. So in left hand side system is very stable. So what we should comment like, initially root locus is stable as all the poles are lying on left hand side. Then it become marginally stable because it is on imaginary axis. So it become marginally stable at k equal to 48. Then it become unstable. It become unstable for k greater than 48. So below value of 48, it is already stable because all poles are lying on left hand side. Then system becomes marginally stable at this value, this and this. This value means k is equal to 48 and omega n is 2.82 radian per second. And then system becomes unstable because it is continuously moving in left right hand side. So you should write, initially all poles are lying in left hand side, so system is stable. Then at k is equal to 48, system is marginally stable. Then for k is greater than 48, system is unstable. That is a complete comment for the given system. Got it? I hope you got this numerical. Again, for practicing, some more numbers will be discussed in the next lecture. So we'll stop here. Thank you.